what am I going to do when they tell me you have to go? And they ship me to South Korea, and I'm there standing there, and I don't know what to do.
Adam Krapser spent his 40th birthday in court, fighting to stay in the only country he knows.
And listen to my voice. I'm an American. I've been here my whole life. I don't know anything else.
Adam and his sister came to the U.S. from South Korea when he was 3 years old. They were later abandoned by their adoptive parents, separated into foster care, and sent on two very different paths. His sister was adopted by a family and got her citizenship. Adam says he ended up with abusive foster parents who neglected to finalize his naturalization. He ended up living on the streets, stealing to survive.
You know, ask yourself as a teenager, you know, what are you going to do if you need a place to live? You know, what are you going to do when you wake up in a park and you're wet every day?
Decades later, Krapser is a husband and a father with another baby on the way. When he tried to update his legal status a couple of years ago, his earlier criminal history raised a red flag for immigration authorities. Now he could be deported to South Korea. He doesn't speak Korean and doesn't think he'd survive.
I won't make it if you send me. So you're sentencing me to death for crimes I've already done hard time for.
In 2000, Congress passed a bill making all international adoptees automatic U.S. citizens, but the law was not made retroactive. That leaves scores of other adoptees at the risk of deportation.
This case is compelling for so many reasons. The Child Citizenship Act should be amended to include kids who were over 18 in 2001 when it was enacted.
Senator Jeff Merkley supports Krapser's fight to stay in the U.S. and is taking action on Capitol Hill. He and another senator are proposing a standalone bill to extend U.S. citizenship to all international adoptees. For Krapser, the stakes couldn't be higher.
Whatever they want me to do, I'll do it, you know, but I need to stay here for my family. Like, it's imperative.